Peter, tell us what's happening with the U.S. consumer. Where are they spending their dollars right now?
Well, we're seeing that the consumer is really spending its discretionary dollars on two items, housing and cars. That's been the big drain on the consumer's wallet. We're not seeing tremendous strength in the apparel sector and other discretionary items.
And any changing preferences or tastes in some of the consumer spending?
You know, I think it's clearly online is it may not be a taste or a preference, but it's definitely a phenomenon. You know, online continues to be the highest growth element of our retail portfolio, where we're seeing 20-30% growth over last year. In the stores, it's kind of 1-2% traffic. So traffic is up very slightly, but overall, it's really online. You know, as far as what people are buying, it's difficult to say.
Right. And how do you distinguish between trends and fads and try to avoid the latter, I presume?
You know, there's always, again, most of our portfolio doesn't have a fashion element to it. For example, we have Petco, and that's primarily dog food, so it's very much a commodity. We do have a few company investments in J. Crew, Topshop, and some other companies, and that is a challenge, and definitely trends affect you know, how robust their retail sales are in any given year.
Right. And speaking of companies like J. Crew and Topshop, how important has non-U.S. expansion been to those brands?
Well, interestingly enough, Topshop, part of the reason they partnered with us is they're a European company and they really want to expand in the U.S. So this is a case, it's a UK-based company that is definitely coming here and moving into Asia. J. Crew, the big push by the board and by the sponsors is to move more into Asia and really expand outside the U.S. And that's happening real time, particularly basically as we speak.
Right. And where do you see the cost pressure within your consumer portfolio?
The main item is employee costs. You have the affordable, you know, Obamacare, the Affordable Care Act is definitely a significant cost item. You know, we have 250,000 employees across our portfolio. And in the retailers, many of them are relatively low wage workers, which they may not have received health care benefits. Now, if they're a full-time employee, they do. And that's definitely a big line item, and additional employee costs is the biggest challenge we have in terms of the income statement of a given retailer.
Right. Maybe switching gears, how's the deal pipeline and outlook for this year?
You know, last year was a challenge. We had we were telling people that we thought the U.S. markets were overheated. And I think the market's waking up to that realization. So we had it was a tricky year. We did a lot of structured deals. We only did one buyout. We did four investments last year, deployed $1.5 billion, but only one was a buyout. This year, you know, things changed quite quickly. This year, with the correction in the market, we're seeing some interesting opportunities in the public markets. At Leonard Green & Partners, we will take positions in public companies in order to start a dialogue with the company and the board. And as we speak, we're building approximately four or five positions in companies that we've tracked for the better part of a decade. We have like a 100 company hit list of companies that we admire, and if their stock's traded at the right level, we'd like to have a position in them.
Right.
And that's what we're doing.
Great.
Auction environment's pretty slow still.